Hey everyone, it's Rita from It's Rita to the Rescue here for Fridays, our last day of the week, Cricut Chat, and I wanted to work on something fun today. I feel like I've been giving you loads and loads of information, so I wanted to do something fun. And this is lobster season for us here in New England. My son is a huge lobster fan. Good morning, Jennifer. Hi, Christy. Good morning. So my son's a huge lobster fan, so I just have to get that out there. He would eat lobsters until he got sick, I think. And he's been known to eat three at a time, which can be a little bit much. But anyway, so I also got a brand new stove this week, new stove installed this week. So I needed a new tea towel that I can use on the stove. And I thought that I would show you this cute little tea towel that we're going to be doing with our Cricut Joy and using our Cricut Mini to make. And I wanted to first I'll say hello, good morning to everyone. I'm glad that you could join me. This project I am doing on the Joy, but just, so you know, it can be done on the Explore or the Maker for sure. And you can also use, I'm using the Mini EasyPress, but you can use your regular EasyPress. Yes, and lobster is a big deal in my house. Growing up was a big deal. And so I designed this cute thing for a shirt, and I thought, boy, it would make a really cute, tea towel. I call them tea towels, but I don't know about you, but I always put my little tea towels, my decorative towels here. I never touch them, but I put them here on my stove. And this is what I'm using today. It's a 15-pack flour sack towels that I got at Amazon. And it says they're pre-washed and pre-shrunk and lint-free. So they're 100% cotton. They are a little bit wrinkly. I did try to press out the wrinkles, but I think that's just sort of the nature of this. And clearly you could do this on a different kind of towel, like if you picked it up at TJ Maxx or whatever. So you don't have to get these particular ones. Maybe you can find ones that are a little more decorative to do. And I've done those before, but I just wanted to make something for him. So the next time he has lobster, he can use it as a bib or something. And in the meantime, I can put it on my stove, on the handle of my oven. So this is a design that I did myself. I designed it from two, first of all, I designed it from this image is available in Cricut Design Space. And this is just a typewriter font. And this is another font. I'm trying to remember what it is. It might be lipstick font, but it was definitely a free font. And was easy to design. I made this also in a larger size. Let me see if I can find it. Yeah, so here's the larger size. Whoop. Why did it do that? So I'm working on my iPad because it's easy to show you that. But you can work on your laptop or your desktop or something like that. But so here is the design. And I used, as you can see, I used this one here, this image, and then also an uploaded image that I got somewhere. So I can't share the design with you because it's from an uploaded image, but you can easily recreate this if you're wanting to recreate this exact same project. So here it is. Let's see. I'm going to try to make it smaller. And I just arranged it the way I wanted it to, and then I cut it out in two separate colors, and I'm going to show you how to do that. And then I'm also going to show you how to put it on using your mini. So let's get started. Something fun for today, Friday, after it feels like it should be the weekend today. I guess because we had the holiday last week or something. But here's what I how I did it. So I designed it here, and I did size it to be able to go on here. It's about 6 inches. Each piece is about 6 inches. And I did cut them on the Joy. And here's how I cut them. I cut them in just everyday iron-on. This is not smart iron-on for the Joy, although you could use that, but I didn't have any. You could also use infusible ink if you wanted to, but I didn't have these particular colors. So I just used my everyday iron-on, which is great. It works great. And I did this in two layers, and I'm going to show you how to do that, okay? So I'm here. I'm on my laptop. I'm sorry, my iPad. Oh, yay. Lisa just got her mini in the mail. They're really fun. They're really fun. I have both the EasyPress and the mini, but I like them both, but I'm just a fangirl, I guess. So anyway, so I have my design here, and I'm going to go and hit make it down here. All right. And I have, just so you know, I have my Joy selected before I even started here. Actually, maybe I should show you how, if you have two machines, this is where you would make your machine selection here. So this is my account. See my picture there? And I click on that. And this is where you would change your machine if you have more than one machine. So in this case, I'm going to choose the Cricut Joy because I want for it to cut on the Joy so you can see it. But I could also do it, like I said, on the Explore or on the Maker, which I have both. So I'm going to hit make it, and it will come up with my choices. Do I want to cut this without a mat? And remember, without a mat means that it's for Cricut Smart Materials, okay? And as I said, when we first started, I didn't have these colors in the Smart Materials, so I'm just going to go ahead and use it on the mat, because everything else that's not a Smart Material goes on a mat. Also, I have choices for card mat and multiple ways, but we're not doing a card today. We're doing an iron-on using everyday iron-on. So I'm going to choose on mat. And you'll see here are my two mats. So it comes up, there's the red mat, there's the black mat. But when I'm doing iron-on, remember that the one important thing that you have to do is you have to mirror. And this is not mirrored because I can actually read it. That's how you can tell. But also it says here at the top, mirror off. Okay, so you want to change both mats to mirror on. And you do that up here where this little, it's like a mat. And there's a number there, and it will come over to like kind of a slide over, and you'll see here I have a choice of project copies, the certain type of mat or no mat, material size, and then the bottom thing is mirror. So I'm going to use that little toggle switch to make it green. I can also go here and do the same thing because we want both of these to be mirrored. Okay, and so now when you go back, you can see it says mirror on this one too, mirror on. So we're going to hit continue because this is the way that it's going to cut out. We did all the right things. We're going to hit continue, and here is where we choose our material size. You set your material. So right now I just have under here my favorites, faux leather, but I'm going to go to all materials here. And I'm going to look for the iron-on section and choose everyday iron-on because that's what I'm using. And it does remind me to mirror and to place my material shiny side down. Okay. It also wants to make sure that I have the fine point blade in there and that I have to then load the material. So let me show you the mat. So I have cut down this everyday iron-on. I find this is the easiest way to do, is to cut it down. And these are actually 6-inch pieces, so I'm using both sides of my mat. And make sure that it's on there. This piece actually is going, there's extra here, so that's why I didn't cut it all the way to the mat. But I did cut this all the way to the mat just to make sure. And I used my trimmer to do that, okay? So now I'm going to do the red piece first. So I have to load my mat into the joy. I'm gonna kind of move it so you can see it and see what it does. So I'm loading. I have to get below these two like guides right here. It's very similar to if you have another machine, you have to load it in. It has to sort of make sure that the mat is aligned and ready to go. And then I just hit go right here, go. And it will start cutting, and you'll see on the screen that it's preparing and it's going to cut. And I just want to show you how quickly it cuts. And it's going to go through and cut out our lobster, the word lobster, and then our image of the lobster. And then when that's done, we're gonna flip this over, take this off, and we're gonna flip it over, and we're gonna do the black. Well, actually, I think this is actually navy, which is fine, because in my example, it really looks really black, but I think it's navy. Yeah, it's navy. So you do have to, if you have two colors, remember you have to cut them out separately, and then you just place them when you're ready to iron them on. You place them, you do one first and then the other. And I'm going to show you how to do that. So let's have it go through. And while I'm waiting for it to cut, I just wanted to remind you that tomorrow night is date night, Cricut Date Night. It's at 7 o'clock here on this channel, Miss Rita to the Rescue. And we are going to have a couple of giveaways tomorrow night. This month, our giveaways are the new infusible ink transfer sheets with a couple of blanks of the new blanks. And that will be fun. But we're also working on Christmas stuff. And it's all Christmas stuff that can be stored away for Christmas. So it's Christmas in July. We start Christmas in July. And it can be stored away for actual Christmas. And so I'm going to hit unload. So do think about coming if you can make it, because it's going to be a lot of fun. So now I'm going to do the black side. Let me just get this going, and then I'll tell you just a tiny bit more. All materials, I'm doing everyday iron-on, and it's loading again. Make sure that my mat is aligned, and I am going to hit go. Now, I will note that it's kind of lifting because my mat is old. I have to get some new mats. So be careful of that because it can interfere with the rollers, and I'm going to help guide it when it goes. So here we go. So while that's cutting, we'll move it out of the way so I can show you how to weed it. So this is, again, this is our iron-on. And if I hold it up really close, I can show you where the cutout is. It's right here. Why am I? Hello. Okay. And I'm going to cut it. So I can keep this little piece that I didn't use. I just like trim it down, and then I turn it over to this side. This is the matte side or the wrong side, and this is where I'm going to do the weeding. So to start weeding, and you usually do it on a flat surface, but to start weeding, you take a weeding tool like this one. Got something stuck on it. Okay, a weeding tool like this one, and we're going to grab the edge of the material. So this is what's called the transfer sheet. It's basically a plastic sheet, and when we go to put it on the towel, it will be kind of like it keeps the heat from hitting the iron-on directly. I think that's how to best explain it. So you first, you grab the iron-on. This is just doing it at first, the bulk part, okay? And then we have to go back and do the the little details. So our black is now done, or navy. And so you're going to use your little pick or whatever you use. Some people use different things. Some people use the true control knife or whatever. And you're just going to peel away the pieces that we don't want, basically. And if you need to, turn it over and you can see, all right, I need to take out the O and the little negative space and the B, R, and then obviously some weeding needs to get done on my lobster. So let's do that. There's the O and the B. I'm gonna move it closer to my face so I can see what I'm doing. Take off these little pieces, and then we're going to be careful here because we got the antenna here for the lobster. We don't want to lift that. And see between his legs, there's a little tiny cutout. So these cutouts can be very detailed. You don't have to worry about them being, you know, too basic. But you have to make sure you weed them correctly. So I'm just going to show you, like, so here, there's like in between the claws and the head. And then also the eyes, which are difficult because they're just two little tiny cutouts. All right. So here, and you see it has the little, I would call those dew claws, but that's probably not the right term. And because we want it to look authentic, right? And there's a little piece here that needs to get pulled off. And then also the eyes, right? Like I mentioned, they're right here. They're teeny tiny. So you have to kind of play with those a little bit. All right. Now there, what will happen is you have like little pieces that get stuck to your transfer sheet. And make sure you remove them because when you put a heat on them, they'll end up getting transferred with the regular transfer that you're trying to do. And then you'll be mad at yourself. So let me just do these eyes really quickly. And you'll do, obviously, a better job than I will because I'm on camera. But here we go. I think I got the eyes. All right. And then for the other letters, it says, I'm just here for the. Actually have some iron-on that I'm going to keep. You never know. You know, I'm a scrap keeper. And then I'm going to take my my weeding tool, my pick, and I'm going to try to grab that, again, grab that little edge there. Oh, I actually did it on the wrong edge, but that's okay. So you take off the majority of it just by peeling it like this. And I do peel it sort of, like kind of like with vinyl, I peel it sort of so that nothing lifts, but it's sticky. It's somewhat sticky, so generally don't have too much lift. And then we're just going to go and do the same thing, which is removing all the negative spaces between the letters, between the S and the T and inside the O. This also would make a great shirt, especially for if you got somebody going to a lobster bake or something. And actually, I think I've made one of these. Yeah, I did. I make one of these for my son for summer. So, okay, so this is it. I actually have this here. I actually cut off. But I'm just here for that. All right. And let's move over here. I have my EasyPress pad, and I'm going to use my EasyPress Mini, which I've got on medium, which is the two lines. How did I know that it was supposed to be on medium? Well, I use the EasyPress heat guide. Do you know about the EasyPress heat guide? It's something that is offered on the Cricut site, and I would definitely recommend that you bookmark, because if you're doing iron-on, there's so many questions like what's the base material, what heat transfer material are you using, and even which EasyPress you're going to use. So you would actually select a certain EasyPress. So in this case, I'm going to choose my Mini. And my heat transfer, I told you I'm doing everyday iron-on. And then my base material, this is 100% cotton. And then I hit apply, and it tells me that I need to preheat for 5 seconds, and then I need it to be on medium. That's what I have it on. And then I have to use constant movement and light pressure. And then I should flip it over and do it for 15 seconds. Okay. And it also shows me how I need to stack it. So there's my mat. There's my substrate or my blank or whatever you want to call it. In this case, it's a towel. And there is my cutout. And there's my Mini. Okay. So, and there's also tons of more information about application and preparing it and everything else. But just so you know, this is really the most important part. I have to preheat. I'm going to do 25 seconds on medium. And I'm going to, that means for both layers, okay? So, and as I said before with this, they're kind of wrinkly, and I did try to sort of smooth them out, but I think that's just the particular towel that I used, and I think putting it about here would be good. So I'm going to start with the black letters or the navy letters, and I'm going to sort of eyeball where I want to put it. I think, you know, we need to leave a little bit on the bottom there. So I think here would be good, but I still need to preheat. So I'm just kind of getting an eyeball, and then I'm going to come back and put this on there. Okay, so let's preheat first. Using the Mini, it's on 2. And I'm preheating. And again, if you don't like this look, you might want to get something like a little more designed to be like a decorative towel. But what I used is these tea towels that I got from Amazon. And I will post a link after I'm done with the video. Okay, so it's kind of warm. Now I'm going to put it back here. One of the things when you're using a press, and particularly I think for the Mini, is you've got to watch out for things like the little dots and then the edges where a letter starts. So I kind of count in my head 25 seconds, and I make sure that I'm doing the 25 seconds like all in all of the areas, because I just don't want anything to lift. And I'm going to show you how to peel it. I peel mine pretty cool because I just feel like it peels better that way. So, see, I'm moving it. I'm making sure I get over here where that I and that apostrophe is. And I think that that has been 25 seconds, probably a little bit more, but I'm a little overachiever, I guess. Now, remember, I have to flip it around and do the back, but this is folded so that I just kind of unfolded it so I can kind of get there on the back. Not explaining things very well today. So, okay. So I'm just, and this part's important too, because it just to kind of like make it grip better. All right. So we have to let it cool just a little bit. It's still pretty hot to the touch. So I'm going to let it cool. In the meantime, I'm going to check out my lobster here. Make sure that I got those eyes. I did. Make sure that I've weeded everything correctly. Also, one of the things, if you're a household that has animals, and like right now, my corgis are shedding like crazy. Sometimes even in the air, the hair will stick to this transfer sheet. And I just cut this out, right? But you'll get a little hair or two there. So you want to make sure you kind of remove that because it will interfere with the transfer. So these eyes are going to be the death of me. These little teeny tiny eyes. Come on, open your eyes, little Mr. Lobster Man. Okay. So, yep, we're cool off. Now, I always start from the corner here, and I peel like this, sort of with my fingers and holding the back, because I don't know, I'm just afraid. and to do it this way a little slow rather than just kind of rip it off, I won't have anything that lifts. And if I do, I can easily put it back and just kind of hit it with the press again. Okay, so there is our first layer. I'm just here for the, and now we're going to get the lobster layer. And I think maybe here, this looks pretty good to me. All right. It's still sort of warm, but if I wanted to, I could just kind of preheat that area just to be on the safe side. Here, I think it gives the lobster enough room. Look at how detailed that lobster is. Oops, and I see something here is not completely weeded between the legs, and I will kick myself later if that showed up that way. So let me go and take your time with this stuff so you don't, you know, this is, it's not permanent, but I mean, you'll notice it. But even if you do notice it, you make a mistake, please don't point it out to somebody else that probably wouldn't notice it. All right, so ready? We're going to do this, and I'm going to make sure I get those antenna. And I'm staying away from this here piece, but I mean, I don't have to be that careful about it. So 25 seconds. So while I'm talking, okay, so Saturday night, we're going to do Christmas cards, and holiday things as well. There's some religious and non-religious, as well as Hanukkah, and a New Year's card as well. And we actually even have, Christmas tags. I'm trying to think what else. Oh, a foldable ornament from Anna Griffin. So do come, because we're going to have a lot of fun. And again, as I mentioned, we're going to do a giveaway as well. And if you can't make it or you've got something else going on, remember you can always catch it on the replay, which is available usually on my Facebook page. And then I put it on my YouTube channel. All the videos are available on the YouTube channel. Okay. So I'm going to flip it again, remember, just to get the back. It's right here. I'm going to do 15 seconds on the back. So we had a lot of fun this week. We did a lot of work in Design Space, and we worked only on Design Space projects. I'm interested in hearing your feedback about how this week went for you. I know it was pretty heady. There were a lot of things that we went over, a few little tricks that we did, and I'd be interested in hearing. Oh, yeah, good. Yes. Okay, so the lobster font, I have to go back and check, and I'll post it in the video when I do the replay. But I think it was lipstick lettering. I'm not terribly sure about that. But the top one is just a typewriter font. All right, so it's kind of cooled down. Okay, it's coming off really well. And I'm gonna make sure I get those really little details like his antenna. Yeah, because you have to be real, real careful there. His eyes kind of came out on this one. I don't think I did a great job of it. But there you go. It's a really great little tea towel. And, oh, good. I'm glad to hear that you learned a lot of stuff this week. I hope I wasn't too detailed, but I wanted to show you some of the little tricks that I've learned from the years of working with Design Space. And I also wanted to spend more time in Cricut Design Space and Cricut Access as well. So that is our tea towel that says, "I'm just here for the lobster." Isn't that great? Could also make a great t-shirt, as I mentioned, or even, I don't know, even a pillowcase, I suppose. Remember, you can do this on any machine. You don't need the Joy. If you have an Explorer, if you have a Maker, of course you can do this on that, on the machine that you have. You can also use your regular EasyPress, or you can use a Mini. And especially because I used Everyday Iron-On, if you don't have a press, you can use your iron and it would stay just as well. And remember, this isn't infusible ink. Infusible ink requires a more polyester blend. This is 100% cotton, but it will wash well. I have confidence in the Cricut Easy, the Cricut Everyday Iron-On. It stays for quite a while. But for this one, it's going to just sit on my oven, but I know that if I wash it, it would still stay really well there. And just get up close so you can kind of see. Isn't that great? All right. Okay, so that's it for today. A nice quick project for today, for Friday. And I do hope that you can come and visit me on Saturday night when we do Christmas in July. But if you can't, we will have it on replay and then we'll start next week. And just a side note about next week, I am going in for surgery on Wednesday of next week. And then there'll be a couple days recovery. So I'm only going to be doing the show on Monday and Tuesday of next week. And then I'll try to pick it up on Friday if I'm doing well, but I'm not sure there. Okay. Thanks, everyone. I really appreciate your comments. I can't read them all right now because of the way that it is my camera is there, but thank you for the feedback. I really appreciate it. And I do use it to try to make things better for you. And I hope you have a lovely day. Enjoy, stay out of the heat, stay out of the sun, and be safe and everything. And see you really soon, I hope.